Then she happened to remember that in a corner of her suitcase were one or two crackers that were left over from her luncheon on the train, and she went to the buggy and brought them. Eureka stuck up her nose at such food, but the tiny piglets squealed delightedly at the sight of the crackers and ate them up in a jiffy. "Now let us go back to the city," suggested the Wizard. "That is, if Jim has had enough of the pink grass." The cab horse, who was browsing near, lifted his head with a sigh.
"I've tried to eat a lot while I had the chance," said he, "for it's likely to be a long while between meals in this strange country. But I'm ready to go now at any time you wish."
So after the Wizard had put the piglets back into his inside pocket, where they cuddled up and went to sleep, the three climbed into the buggy and Jim started back to the town.
"Where shall we stay?" asked the girl.
"I think I shall take possession of the house of the sorcerer," replied the Wizard, "for the prince said in the presence of his people that he would keep me until they picked another sorcerer, and the new princess won't know but that we belong there." They agreed to this plan, and when they reached the great square, Jim drew the buggy into the big door of the domed hall.
"It doesn't look very homelike," said Dorothy, gazing around at the bare room, "but it's a place to stay, anyhow."
"What are those holes up there?" inquired the boy, pointing at some openings that appeared near the top of the dome.
"They look like doorways," said Dorothy, "only there are no stairs to get to them."
"You forget that stairs are unnecessary," observed the Wizard. "Let us walk up and see where the doors lead to."
With this, he began walking in the air toward the high openings, and Dorothy and Zeb followed him. It was the sort of climb one experiences when walking up a hill, and they were nearly out of breath when they came to the row of openings, which they perceived to be doorways leading into halls in the upper part of the house. Following these halls, they discovered many small rooms opening from them, and some were furnished with glass benches, tables, and chairs, but there were no beds at all.
"I wonder if these people never sleep," said the girl.
"Why, there seems to be no night at all in this country," Zeb replied. "Those colored suns are exactly in the same place they were when we came, and if there is no sunset, there can be no night."
"Very true," agreed the Wizard. "But it is a long time since I've had any sleep, and I'm tired, so I think I shall lie down upon one of these hard glass benches and take a nap."
"I will, too," said Dorothy, and chose a little room at the end of the hall. Zeb walked down again to unharness Jim, who, when he found himself free, rolled over a few times and then settled down to sleep, with Eureka nestling comfortably beside his big bony body. Then the boy returned to one of the upper rooms, and in spite of the hardness of the glass bench, was soon deep in slumberland.